Hello everyone, I'm Durgesh Sahani and we are creating series of video tutorials for complete user registration system in PHP and MySQL by using AJAX. So in the previous session we have seen how to create a database and tables and save this data to that table. Now in this session we are going to see how to send activation link to the user email. Okay, so let's start now. Over here, once data gets saved to the database, then we want to get the last created ID. Okay, so that thing you can get it like this, last ID equal to this object, and then connection object, and then last insert ID. Okay, and see, this connection object is we have here, right? On constructor we are creating it, and this is declared over here. One more thing, make it public, otherwise we will not be able to access it. So we get the last ID. Now we'll create one token. So token we can create by using any algorithm, hashing algorithm basically. So I'm going to use SHA-1. So just say, so it will return me, I think 40 characters alpha numeric value. So that we get, and now we have to prepare the URL. So URL equal to http://, and then concat it with $_server, and here server_name, so it will return the host, and then say user, as we are on here you can see user folder, so that folder name, then file name, so just say verify.php. okay, and it will come with some data. So let's say id equal to, you can say $lastId, and again concat with token, so and token equal to $token. Okay, so we have prepared the URL. Now we can create a HTML equal to, we can say div opening and closing, and here we'll say whatever the message you want to print. So I'll just say this one, thanks for registering with localhost, please click the link to complete your registration, and here you can use one br, and after that your URL, so just concat it with like this $URL. Okay, so simple, fine. Now whatever you want, you can create your HTML like this, and we are going to use a PHP mailer library. So if you are aware about it, then that's fine. If you not know about PHP mailer, so I already have created one series of video tutorials for sending mails from localhost by using SMTP and PHP mailer, so you can go and check that videos. So I'm going to use the same code, so just copy this code and we'll paste it over here. Okay, and we will remove some unnecessary part like this, we don't want to send any attachment, so delete this thing. See, we have created an object, and see, this file is not in our directory. Either you can paste this whole folder mailer to this file, this folder, or you can go to one directory back, and then this mailer folder, and then file name. The same thing you have to do for credential.php. okay, so in credential.php I have this email and password, so I have defined the these two constant over there. Okay, so make sure that you are setting these two things, and then we have to set this address. This address you can set as we are already setting it to this object, so just copy it and done. So here just say get email, so you'll get the email address over here. This is fine, this is okay. So subject you can change to confirm or verify your password, right? Your confirm your email, okay? And this is body, so on body you can change it to $HTML what we have. Okay, so this variable we already have created over here, HTML. Now, and we don't want any alternate body, so just remove it. We are done. And if you want to change this thing, you can change, but I'll keep as it is. Now, if all good, then we should get an email. Okay, so just change this message. This one, if it is failed, then show this message, else done. And here you can say please confirm your email, or just please verify your email, right? Like this, you can show anything. Let's try now. If all good, then it should work now. Just refresh. So I'm just entering my name, mobile number, and then email. So I'm going to enter my valid email address @gmail.com, then password, confirm password. Okay, once I click on this registered, it should trigger a mail if all good. So it is taking time. Here you can show some spinner as it is working, right? So congratulations, your registration done on our site. Please verify your email. So if I'll go here and check, then here I have one value here. So see, you are getting all these details over here. And if I open my email address, I should get one email. Here you can see. So thank for registering with localhost. Please click this link. So the same message, and here you can see this is the URL verify.php, and ID we are getting. So here you can see the ID is 2. So that ID and this token. So once you click on this link, it will try to go to verify.php with the same data. Now here we have to write the logic for verifying this ID. If it is existing in our database, then we have to verify it. So that part we will see in the next session, but we have to do one more thing. See, if this email is already there, then we have to validate for it, else it will if I click on this register again, you can see I'll get one more data with the same email address. So you can validate it for unique value. Just delete it now. So we'll do that thing. Okay, and go to the operations and make it 3. So here, and if you see, I should get one new email again. See, with the same email I got a new activation link. So we have to validate for it. So before save, we'll check here if that email is already exist. And there are two way: either you can go into the database and structure, and then this email. So you can make it and there I think unstructured only, you can make it a unique key. So this email address, you can say it unique, so it will accept a unique value only. So if I'll try to insert it again, here you can see, so I'm getting an error, a duplicate entry for this. Okay, so one way is this, and another way is hit one SQL. And the error we are getting over here in insert, so it is not looks good, right? Fatal error we are getting. So you can handle it. Once executed, then make it into try and catch block. See, like this, just paste it over here, and whatever error you are getting, just echo it $e get message. So if you save it, click on this link again, see, you are getting this error like this, right? Duplicate entry, email key failed to save. So, and fail to save, we are getting it from here, this one else. So here you can give one space. Okay, so like this, one way is this one to handle it, and another way is you can write one SQL over here for over here. Public function get user by email. So now we'll write one SQL statement over here, and that thing we can directly write this thing. So just change it to select star from table, and table name is, here we have users, right? This one, select star from users where email equal to colon email, and we can bind it with like this. Oops, just bind it, and once it done, again we can use this try and catch again. Okay, so execute it. If it executes successfully, then call one fetch method to get the data. So we can use dollar statement fetch all. Okay, and here we have to specify one attribute, so PDO, in which format do you want to get the data. So we'll say associative, actually you have to say fetch underscore associative. Okay, so it will return the associative array, and we can store it somewhere like dollar user, and we'll return it from here. Okay, done. So we'll get this user data, or you can write outside over here somewhere like this. So in action.php file here, before saving, we'll call one more function on dollar object. Call this function get this one, and we already have set it this email address, so it will, and here we'll say dollar user data. We'll check one condition, let me print it, so we'll get to know what data we are getting. Exit. So if you click it here, so here you can see we are getting this data, right? Okay, let it be. See, here you can see ID and name, everything we are getting. So we have to verify this email address. So we'll check one condition. If, and actually you can do one thing, you can call current function, so it will return the so it will be the single array. So directly you can say email equal to this email, this one. If both are same, then we'll throw an error, echo email is already registered, okay, and exit. So let's check it again. Once you click here, so email ID is already registered. Register or registered, you can say. Okay. So this kind of message you can show. If I change this address, let's delete this thing. Click. So it will try to send the, it will try to insert that data into database and then try to send the email address. Okay. So if you check here. Okay, so I have entered the invalid address. So I think that mail should be triggered to this person. Okay, so this is a very simple example, guys, how to send the activation link to the registered user. In the next session, I'll show you how to verify that email address. Okay, so thank you very much, guys, for watching. And if you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.